happen. I wanted to see if I could get you to talk about something, but I'm not going to do the normal like time thing. I just want to talk. So I got an email this morning, which has been like super common recently. It's been really, really cool. We don't share them a lot, but they're really great when we get them. And this is from a teacher who runs a grid method in her classroom. And we've gotten a lot of these recently, and we've been doing a lot of work with schools on the grid method, specifically how it connects to remote learning. But we have so many teachers that are coming to us and telling us, like, this is exactly what I needed. It's helped me relieve the stress. I know what I need to do. I'm not worried about bouncing between, you know, because my school bounces based on cases, right? So I'm virtual. I might be hybrid. I might be in person. And it's just the way that the grid method just connects with things. So I know, obviously, I think everyone listening probably knows that you run the grid method in your classroom as well. And you're, I guess, recently found out you're kind of bouncing and changing the way, but you've been remote. It might be different now. So I'm wondering if you could kind of share how you're utilizing the grid method, but really just how it connects to remote learning and how you've been able to sort of adapt by utilizing that. Does that make sense? Am I asking a good question here?
No, it's a good question. It's one that I know you just said you got emails about. I actually have been talking about it nonstop in all of our live videos. It's all people ask me about. So this is good to talk on. I think the main things to highlight is that regardless of the type of environment you're teaching in right now, right? If you're listening and you're like, oh, I'm in remote or I'm in hybrid or I'm all fully in person, the reality is that no matter where you are right now, you need to be prepared to make a shift. And that shift could come, you know, 6 months from now. It could come 2 weeks from now. It could come later this afternoon. I know that's stressful. I didn't mean that. For everybody, take a deep breath. Deep breath in, deep breath out. You'll be fine. But I myself am like finding that we're making a shift, you know, coming mid-October. And so I could really start thinking about completely changing every element of my classroom, right? If I get to have the ability to have students in person, how do I want to shift my instruction? But I think the beautiful gift that the grid method gave me was that all of these foundational elements of the grid method so easily shift and ebb and flow regardless of the environment I'm in, that way, while some elements might change if we go back in person in a hybrid model or anything in between, a lot of like the classroom management elements, the day-to-day routines don't change at all. And I say that in like a really calming way. So there might be certain things that I'm going to figure out, like how I, you know, manage students that are remote and how I manage students in my classroom that are physically there. Or there might be things that change where I could do conferences not only through Google Meets, but now I can do it in person, right? Like those logistical elements, I now get the opportunity to think about. But when it comes to students advocating for their needs, having like a self-paced mastery framework where students understand what they're headed to, that growth mindset that we carry the whole time, how I communicate with families, how students set goals for themselves and reflect on their days, all those elements literally do not change regardless of the environment. So when my students get the call saying, hey, today that you're in person, guess what? For the next 2 weeks, because a case came up, we're now shifting to remote. My students don't miss a beat because nothing really changes besides that I, you know, don't get to see their beautiful face in person. Every other element of their learning, every other element of them taking ownership over their learning and advocating for their needs not only stays the same, but literally has the same routines as well. And so I really think that that's a saving grace every educator is on the hunt for right now is how do I set up a routine that I can teach my students that no matter what happens, it doesn't feel like the whole world's coming down on them. And so routines is a big element of that comfortability. I know I myself as a sixth grade math teacher, this is the first time they're at our middle school. This is the first time they have more than one teacher. They have eight teachers, holy cow. And so the more we can help with those routines, the better. So if you're listening right now and you use the grid method, you know what I'm talking about. If you don't use the grid method, I just want you to know there are so many classroom management strategies within that grid method framework that I'd love to share with you. Even if you never go like full grid, I love that. Somebody told me that the other day, I'm going full grid. I'm like, oh, I didn't know that phrasing was a thing, but go for it.
It's a thing.
It's a thing. There's just little classroom management elements I hope every teacher really starts to look at because we survived the first few weeks. Congratulations. but now we want to make sure that we can survive the rest of the year. And so I think routine is essential. And so whether you're using a routine from the grid method or something else, I wish you all the best for finding the perfect routine.
Awesome. Appreciate you sharing that. So you can find out more. Go to teachbetter.com/thegridmethod. There's a free course on it over at teachbetteracademy.com. And you can also check in. By the way, you know, Ray says she's been talking about it a lot. One of the times that she's talking about that is on our, you know, our bi-weekly check-ins and in our Facebook group. So that's just teachbettergroup.com. So you can catch more of that there. So what did you have to add? You're doing this.
There's also a few free downloads we've added to our download space. Like, if you guys haven't been there, teachbetter.com/free resources, I think it might be.
Free-resources, yeah.
Yeah, just go to teachbetter.com and go to free downloads. It's super easy, but there's a lot of like small, little, quick classroom management tips there as well. So it depends on what you're looking for.
Yep.